Are you wearing glasses or contacts while watching the Rhode Show? Well, if so, it could be because you have myopia. It's very common, so common in fact that about a third of us have it, including me. I recently took a trip to Hayden Optometrics to find out what we can do to fix it.
You're blurry already. I can't even read my ring right now. This is bad.
Sound familiar? Chances are it's myopia.
Most people don't know that it's called myopia. It is nearsightedness to most people, which means your visual correction is set kind of more up close and the distance is blurry, which requires either glasses or contacts to be able to see well.
Now, this is something that a lot of people have, almost a third of the population in the United
States. And growing. Since the 1980s, it's really becoming more like an epidemic in the United States.
The worse it gets.
Correct.
I mean, even sometimes the thicker the glasses you need, right?
Not just the thicker the glasses you need, but the increased risk of retinal holes, tears, detachments when you're older. It really is a health risk to allow somebody to get more nearsighted.
I got glasses at the early age of 8, and it was because I couldn't see the board. That was one of the warning signs. What are some other things that we should be aware of?
Squinting. Headaches. See? Squinting, yep. Making your pinhole.
Actually, I can see it like this.
Do I still look as cute as I did before?
Yeah. Who said that?
Glasses and contacts help people like me, but now there's another option.
It's called orthokeratology. We call it Ortho-K for short. We fit our nearsighted patients and kids with lenses that look and feel like the old hard lenses. They put them in, they go to bed, they get up in the morning, take them out, and they see all day.
So what are these magical little lenses doing?
If you can imagine that their cornea is too steep, and we need to flatten it. So the pressure of the lids on the lens at night makes a shift in the cornea, in the surface of the cornea, flattens it. It's good for about 18 hours, and by then they're going back to bed and putting them back in.
The lenses are great for kids.
When you fit them in those lenses, they really tend to stop changing. There's no guarantee, but it is the best weapon we have to reduce the risk of increased nearsightedness. Better one? Two.
Two.
So if you have an active kid, you might want to try them.
For me, I switched to contacts because I was playing sports. The glasses kept hitting me in the face.
Exactly. Imagine swimming. Where contacts is not that great of an option, the Ortho-K works great. They have nothing in their eyes. Which K is clearer?
The one on the left. I can see!
I can see. Now, if you're thinking, well, I've been told not to sleep with my contacts in, that's true, but that's for soft lenses. Dr. Hayden assures us that the hard lenses used in the Ortho-K are very safe. And if you're contemplating LASIK as an option, he suggests waiting until at least your mid-20s because you don't want to have the procedure done and then have your prescription change. So if you think Ortho-K is for you or your child, go to our website, roadshow.com, for a link to theirs.